Hi everybody, welcome back to Discovering Ultibo series. This is episode 2. We're going to do some exploring USB today. I think a lot of people, when they hear the words no operating system or bare metal embedded, they think no features, limited features, not so much capability as an operating system. Well, we're going to show a bit of what Ultibo Core can do with USB devices today. So we've got our Raspberry Pi 2 here. Got a USB extension cable just plugged into it. Got a little keyboard dongle and a little tiny cheap keyboard. We've got a little demo app here with the console shell on the top so we can do some console commands. And we've got the logger window on the bottom just to show what's happening. You probably can't read the text, but that's not really the point. You'll get what's going on from what happens as we go along. If I just have a look, I can type DIR and there's the contents of our SD card. So this is a standard console shell that you get with Ultibo Core. So we'll just switch to the computer for a moment and just have a look at the code. This will be on GitHub so that you can try it out yourself. So if I have a look here, I've got the project open. It's fairly much a standard Raspberry Pi 2 project, just the standard units. We've got the console and the console shell, the shell file system, so we get all those commands like DIR, copy, delete, all that sort of stuff. We just set some colors, white on black, and then we create a console shell window so that we can have that at the top. Then we create a console logger so we can have that at the bottom, and when we halt the main thread, there's nothing much to it. It's pretty simple stuff. So let's switch back to the Raspberry Pi and try out what we can do with USB. So now the first thing, this being a Raspberry Pi, you would think that you can't unplug the SD card because the operating system as such runs off it. Well, not in the case of Ultibo. We can take the SD card out and we can then go DIR again and it's gone. We can put it back in like that and we can go DIR and it's back again. We can even take it out and put another one in, a completely different one. And if we slide that into his socket, DIR on that one, and there's not much on that one. So no limitations with Ultibo Core. You can swap and change as you like. Now we can take a normal USB stick and just plug it in there up the right way. You see that lots of logging entries come up when I do that. And if I go drive on the console, we'll see we now have two drives. If I switch to D drive and go DIR, DIR slash S, can't find the S. You see there's quite a few files on there. I can just unplug that and we go drive and he's gone again. We can take a standard little 4-port hub and just plug that in, and then we can plug the stick in there and we can go drive and he's back again. DIR slash S, and there's all our files again. We can even be so bold as to plug another one in, and that's recognized. We go drive, and now we have three. And if we look at E drive, we have some other stuff on there. We can take those out, and we can take something like a little standard, this is an SD card reader, or card reader, multi-card reader, and we just plug that in as well. Get the plug up the right way. Now, if we go drive, we only have our C drive. There's nothing else there because there's no SD card in that one at the moment. If we take our SD card, find the micro SD slot, which is there, plug him in there, and then go drive, we have two. D drive, DIR, and that's our original SD card that we're booting from. So we can plug that out as well. That goes away. We can take something a bit more serious, like a Seagate hard disk. This is a standard 3 terabyte Seagate hard disk. We need some power for him, so we plug him into his power. And we need a USB 3 cable. So we plug that in as well. In the back there. And we'll plug that into the hub, like that. His light comes on. Now these devices take a few seconds to spin up, so you'll see that it'll start blinking and we'll get a logger entry to say insert, and then we type drive and we see we've got C and D. He's an NTFS drive, fixed disk as well, not a removable. We can change to D and we can go DIR, and there's a lot of stuff on there. I won't go DIR/S on that one because I know there's hundreds of thousands of files on there and you don't want to wait while all that happens. So I can pull that out, pull the power out so I don't drag it across the desk, take our hard disk away, grab something like a little USB 3 hub, plug him into power, and plug the USB 3 cable in the back of him. Take that, and while not the best idea in the world, plug that straight into our USB 2 hub. Now there's nothing to see there, but we can plug our USB stick straight into the USB 3 hub, go drive, and now we have D drive back again. We can change to D, DIR/S, and there's all our video files back again. Some of my video collection. We can unplug that, and we can, to make some room, take that out of there, take that little hub out, put that out of the way, plug that one back in there, so we've got our USB hub again, and we can take something like a USB removable CD, and we can plug that straight into our USB 3 hub. Now, don't plug one of these straight into your Raspberry Pi. It doesn't have enough power to actually run the motors in one of these, so you do need a powered hub. But if we plug that with the cable up the right way, in there, you'll see that we get lots of logger messages. We'll go drive, and there's no drive there because there's no CD in it. If I take a CD and stick that in the drawer there, slip him in. Again, it takes a few seconds to spin up, but we should see an insert message come up on the console here. And then we go drive, and we have D drive, which is a CDFS CD-ROM. We can go D, DIR/S, and we can see the contents of the CD-ROM. Now, when we've had enough of that, we can simply go disk, eject, CD-ROM 0, and Ultibo will eject it for us. All nice and simple. So there it is. You have all of this in your hands. It's all included in the source. You can do any of this stuff yourself, and you can use it in your projects. So, you know, have an explore. Look around. Try out these things. Try out this demo on GitHub. And we'll see you next time for the next episode of Discovering Ultibo. Thanks very much for watching.